The Baba Yaga dissonance. Oh, this was really annoying at the end, but actually it was pretty good at the beginning. It was pretty fun to work out. So let's go on the ride. Okay, so we've got two targets. They're both two of the pianists, or not the pianists, the cellists or the musicians, whatever you want to call them. They're wearing the white jackets and they're on the main stage near the front of the map. So essentially what we're going to do is just kill them with an explosion. So we're going to use two karma shots just to knock those two out. We're going to use the breach charge to knock the third one out. Reason being, we need a propane flask. So we're going to take this disguise, we're going to pick up the propane flask, and don't forget the breach charge that I threw. So yeah, simple enough kill. We're just going to use the breach charge, the propane flask, and we're going to create ourselves a nice homemade accidental explosion. So nothing too creative about this one. The difficulty really, as far as if you're trying it on your own, without this video or without a guide in this sort of vein, is how do you create the accident? And that's the bit I struggled with for maybe 10-15 minutes. I couldn't actually find a propane flask. So once you actually realise where one is, it's not actually that hard. So you can get on the stage in this disguise. As far as I can tell, it's probably one of the few disguises you can actually come on the stage in. So yeah, I threw that. I was hoping for a better reaction than what I got, but hey ho. And yeah, once the propane's down, put the breach charge near it and step far enough away and you can kaboom it. I actually struggled here in the sense that I was trying to think, can I get the left pianist, well, no, I won't say pianist, they aren't pianists, get the left musician nearer to the right, but he wasn't budging. I realised soon after that they're blindfolded and deaf, so that really didn't help. But yeah, put it in the centre and it should be a big enough explosion to kill them both. So don't faff around with coins, you can just drop the propane flask with the breach charge and it'll create a nice explosion. It's not as difficult as I made it look there, and hopefully in a later level I'll be able to demonstrate it much more clearly. So we're going on to level 2. Level 2 adds one more target, and I'm not particularly happy how this escalates. Level 2's target is the cellist, who's by Janus's funeral, or Janus's wake even. So yeah, it's quite an obvious target, it's out in the open, and I do believe there's a very good way of taking her out as far as speed, but I am not happy about the way I have to involve her in level 3. I seem to be going to level 3 in my videos a lot lately, but the fact is level 3 is becoming much more difficult than it needs to be, so I wouldn't mind some opinions on that. Anyway, this time we're going to start in the kitchen. Did I start in the kitchen last time? Oh yeah, well, anyway, I'm starting in the kitchen. And the idea is we're just going to go into the kitchen storage room just to get a karma from the storage thing. Last time I used it as my main weapon, but for the new target we do need to kill with a pistol shot, so I had to bring the pistol in with me. There's also an added condition that now any NPC that you eliminate or subdue with the karma has to be done so with a headshot. So it does mean that these kills are slightly more difficult. For instance here, I'm really trying to gauge where to aim it. This guy was just moving to troll me, I think. And yeah, I managed to get the headshots off alright, but it's not ideal when all you want to do is just do 3 consecutive knockouts. So that didn't help either. I was really hoping I could just throw the breach charge and knock him out, but he was having none of it, so I just snuck along gear, got the soda can, and threw it at the back of his head before he could wake one of his buddies up. So yep, same as before, we're just going to change disguise, we're going to pick up the breach charge and the propane flask, go down. As I've said, it's a pretty repeatable routine for the first 2 levels. The addition of the new target doesn't really complicate this matter. In fact, it's very simple in this level. It is a little bit random, so I cannot guarantee it will work 100% with the new target, but this one I feel fairly certain offering 100% assurances. So as you can see, we go up the steps, we're going to just drop the breach charge, which will also drop the propane flask, go down the stairs, and just make sure you don't get stuck on that thing, and detonate it. The idea is the enforcer will go to investigate the explosion, and that'll just give you a bit of leeway as far as moving around this area. You don't really need the leeway, as you saw, I didn't have any difficulties, but if you just won't go straight through the gate thing, then yeah, no problem. Anyway, this new target, it's a pretty simple way to kill her. We're going to climb the stairs, and there are 2 guards who patrol in this area. As it turns out, I was just getting up here as they were patrolling to the other side of their little patrol section. So all I did was aim and shoot. And you've got an exit just behind you, so you do have to be a little bit quick, because there is a chance that there will be just an NPC in general who will see the kill. So don't dawdle them once you've taken the shot. That's the only thing I can advise, because I have had bodies found for that. So yeah, I'm not going to offer 100% reliability, but it can work. So you're going to see why I'm offering cans in level 3, because cans are better than cannots. So yeah, level 3, this was a doozy. We've got a new target and he's actually in the castle, and he's just above the Ark members, is it? Or the Ark, oh, I can't remember the classes. It's basically the hardest area to get to for one of them. There is also the added condition that we've also got a elimination streak timer. So once you've killed one target, you've got 60 seconds to get to the next target and kill them. For the record, I've got motorcycles going off in the background. If that comes off in the recording, I do apologise. So this time we're starting up here, and we're going to throw a remote breach charge straight away to draw a elite guard inside. I'm also dropping the breach charge just to get him deeper into this area. We've smuggled in the karma again, so we're just going to the little briefcase area over here where I've smuggled it in. I wish I could remember the names, but honestly, who remembers the names that well? Anyway, what we're going to do, through this door, subdue this guy. Now try and drag him as close to the wall as you can, because there is an NPC who comes in this area and she has found the body a few times when I've done this route. So just try and hide the body as close to the wall as you can, and then when she turns to leave, she probably won't see it. I say probably, because again, cans rather than cannots. Okay, so I really don't like how I'm meant to do this, but yeah, we're going to shoot the camera, and the only way I've found to actually take this target out is using the glitch. So aim a karma shot at the target, make sure it's a headshot, switch quickly to the Krugermeier and take a headshot. I really wish there was a more efficient way of doing this, because I can believe there is a way to do it, but the fact is there added condition from the last level saying that you're not allowed to hit another part of the body. It also means that, for instance, you can't make a target, well, I know he isn't a guard, but he's a target. You can't make him walk off and sort of try and heal himself up or something. He will just, it'll be game over as soon as you shoot him. So the only way I could think to do it, considering he's both blind and deaf as well, is I thought we're just going to have to use the karma technique. The longer method I can only assume would be to incapacitate all of the NPCs in that area. And considering people pass through like the constant, that is very difficult. So I use the karma technique here as well, simply because of the elimination streak timer. So yeah, just aim for the head, then aim for the head again with the Krugermeier. So nothing too complicated. This last one gets slightly more complicated though, because we've got a disguise that isn't suitable to get on the stage with the propane flask. So what I've done with this route, I've put along the ICA remote micro explosive, and I'm going to place that on the stairwell. That way it'll be an explosion that we can create to turn the guards around. So as you can see, place the explosive just on the wall. You can place it on the ground, wherever you like, just make sure it's this way. Just go past the guards, just for make sure that you're near it at the stage. Detonate the explosive, pick up the propane flask. I actually dropped it a bit further than I realized. So yeah, then go up the stage, crouch, because there might be enforcers in the crowd who can see you. Then drop the breach charge so the propane flask drops as well. Go back off the stage and detonate. I even got caught by that thing again. So that is level 3, and it was quite speedy. I'm happier with that part. I just believe there is a way of doing it all without using the karma gunshot technique, which I really don't like in the game. It does make me wonder if the devs are actually considering making it a legitimate killing method, because if that's the case, then fair enough. But as things stand, it's a bug, and I don't particularly like endorsing a bug because it's not good. So I might do this video again in the future when I've had a bit more of a play around with it and seen how to get that third target, the new one. But until then, this has been Josh from JJ's Productions. Like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now, folks.